The Medanta Institute of Liver Transplantation and Regenerative Medicine was launched about 7 years ago with the idea of making a world-class comprehensive liver center for adults and children, which provides multidisciplinary care for all liver disease patients, patients with liver failure and liver cancer, all under the same roof. Having done about 2,500 liver transplants, we are currently the largest living donor liver transplant program in India and one of the world's largest such programs. So on the clinical front, our focus is on excellent patient care and patient safety. On the teaching front, we have established fellowship training programs in all the major subspecialties of liver transplantation. Research is an integral part of the Medanta Liver Institute. In fact, if you're at the Medanta Liver Institute, you have to be passionate about research. So we are currently working on novel biomarkers and immunotherapeutics in HCC and hepatic organoids. Hepatic organoids is something that will, in future, perhaps give us the ability to make artificial livers.
Over the years, we have gained a lot of experience by doing so many transplants. So the advantage of that has been that we have protocolized our procedures. On the other side of it, we're doing more complex surgeries like domino liver transplant, combined liver and kidney transplant, coronary artery bypass graft and liver transplant.
At our institute, we've always tried to leverage multidisciplinary expertise with the latest in technology. For example, before the actual surgery, we have technology to perform virtual surgery on the computer console. We look at 3D liver imaging systems. We have high-end interventional radiology and CyberKnife. And among the operative techniques, we routinely do laparoscopic surgery and robotic liver surgery.
My role is mainly a surgical part in liver transplantation and minimal invasive surgery. In that comes the laparoscopic surgery and robotic surgery. And primarily, it is the robotic surgery. A robot is advanced in minimal invasive surgery, which at one side gives the advantage of better cosmesis and at the same time, high level of precision.
Each donor and recipient surgery is pre-planned, and the radiology takes the most important part in it, especially in the donor surgery. So there are various series of scans. So the radiology for donor is essential and mandatory. The triphysic CT will give us the variations in the anatomy, the length, the diameter, the portal venous divisions, and the hepatic venous anatomy, which is very important for the liver transection. The recipient evaluation is done to find out if there is portal vein thrombosis, portal vein flow, and for the evaluation of HCC apart from the generalized evaluation.
Post-transplant care and recovery has really changed in the last few years. So immunosuppression is generally started on the day two or day three after a liver transplant. And we generally go slow. We start with lower doses and then escalate. We at Medanta believe in tailored immunosuppression, and that's the concept now. So he would get immunosuppression according to the cause of his liver disease.
Post-transplant recipients are prone to infection. In order to ensure a quick recovery in these patients, we have strict infection control protocols in place, which include double barrier nursing with air quality control, contact precautions, and also a regular review of our antibiotic policy. We try to teach our patients how to live with their liver transplants by educating them about their immunosuppression and the importance of a very strict regular follow-up after transplant.
Liver transplant in children is more challenging than adults, both medically and surgically, especially in a living-related transplant setup. And I'm happy to share that the youngest or the smallest, lightest baby in the world, 2.2 kg with neonatal hemochromatosis, underwent a successful liver transplant at our center. I think it's the passion amongst all of us to ensure that we provide the highest level of care. And thanks to the electronic media with the availability of WhatsApp and email, it gets more easy for us to be connected like a family. And I'm truly privileged to say that I act not only as a doctor, but as a mother to these children.
Patient, meri beti hai. Jab hum is hospital mein aaye, meri beti bahut serious thi. और हमें डॉक्टरों ने ये सजेशन दिया कि इसका किडनी और लीवर बहुत ट्रांसप्लांट ही होगा 9 महीने तक इसका डायलिसिस भी चला कैडेट ट्रांसप्लांट हो गया और अब इसका जीवन बिल्कुल ठीक ठाक है.
माय फादर वाज सफर्ड फ्रॉम लिवर सिरोसिस सो Medanta एडवाइज्ड अस टू गेट अ स्वैप केस इन विच आई हैड गिवन अ पार्ट ऑफ लिवर टू अनदर पेशेंट एंड हिज सन गेव द पार्ट ऑफ लिवर टू माय फादर. We lost all hope. By the grace of God, we found another family and we all are leading a good life.
Aim is at Medanta for us to provide a very safe and absolutely certain environment where they can go through this complex surgery in a safe way. Nothing satisfies more a donor than seeing a recipient whom he has donated and the patient is doing well after surgery. That probably is the greatest, you know, you could say the gift the donor actually has after the surgery.
The to-do list for the Medanta Liver Institute for the future is very long. But what we would like is to establish our laparoscopic donor hepatectomy program, to standardize the use of machine perfusion to improve the yield and quality of deceased donor livers, and for our research to bear fruit.